Alright, a bonus effect for now is the vanishing. Oh, gingerbread man, okay? So the effect I'm gonna teach you today is the vanishing gingerbread man. It's really simple. First, you need to buy an obese gingerbread man. And then you take the gingerbread man. It helps if you have a cup of drink and just vanish it this way. Vanish. Alright, so I'm back here today just to cover something really simple. Actually a few things, okay? Because I've been asked a few times how do we do certain things. Like in my previous effect, I did a one-hand shuffle, okay, to hide the card. So it's something like, let me try to get the card again. I've got a red card here. I snap my finger and I reveal that this red card vanished and actually changed, okay? I snap my finger and I say that, well, it changed to another card. And then I actually showed that their selected card was now somewhere in the center of the deck. So I did a one-hand card. Now, how do I do a one-hand card? And that's what I'm gonna cover in this particular video, okay? It's really very simple. Now, it takes a lot of practice, but it's simple and it's idea behind it, okay? So the idea behind this is that as you take the stack of cards, okay, you hold them with one thumb here, your finger, index finger here, and your last finger here, okay, and these two finger here. Some people hold it this way, okay? It's really up to you. I hold it this way, my last finger here, because then it squares everything up. But if you want it this way, it's okay. Now the idea is really to trust in your sense of feel. So from here, if you actually hold up half a stack of these cards, okay, it's actually pushing up. Your thumb pushes about half the stack of these cards up this way. Okay, so you're here, your thumb pushes half the stack of this card up. That causes this thing to open up. Okay, at the same time, because these fingers, 1, 2, it's actually clipping onto the ends of the deck. So therefore, when I pull this up, the rest of the deck falls down, okay? But it falls down in a controlled manner. It doesn't just fall down by itself like that, okay? It falls down in a controlled manner. So it's like that. controlled because there are two fingers at each end, and they kind of like control how the cards fall. So you hear, and comes down, okay? Let the bottom stack come down. Now once you're in this position, this index finger releases itself, the rest of the stack below will fall down and rest onto your palm area. Notice that there is in fact a gap in between, okay? So it's, you do not have to make it rest entirely on the palm. Now once you're in this position, here, okay, and then you release half. Once you're in this position, what you want to do next is this index finger bends and presses onto the bottom of the stack. Now, but not just anywhere, you want to press on the outer bottom, okay, around here. The idea now is to control the cards, and that's why you require practice. While your thumb releases the top stack, your finger here, it doesn't really have to release, okay, it's like supporting lightly. Your finger at the bottom, your index finger, pushes the bottom stack up. Effectively, you may remove your thumb. You do not need to, but I'm just showing you how stable this can get. Okay, you may remove your thumb and continue pushing the rest of the stack up. Now, once this stack has cleared the top stack here, this index finger bends down. You see it's bending? And then this stack closes on top. So that is the one hand shuffle, okay? Or one, yeah. You can cut the deck in with one hand, okay? Let me show you again. From here, push off half. The bottom half falls down in a controlled manner. You can see I'm controlling with my fingers here and the last finger at the back. You can tell that I'm controlling because as much as I can bring it down, I can at any point of time bring it up, okay? So here, half comes down. Index finger comes into the bottom, outer bottom, push it up along the side. Look, my thumb is still holding. If your thumb is too small, your fingers are too short, you think it's too short, I'm telling you there's no such thing, but if you think that your thumb is too short, release the thumb, it's okay, it's stable. Once this deck comes out, top pack, the bottom pack comes out, this top stack will rest on your finger, bend your finger down, and come in again. Here. Now there are some versions in which when they teach this, it is very hard to control the card. Reason why is because their last finger is here. So when you're in this position, you come up here, you push up. You see? Now this stack here has to rest only on your finger. So it may fall to the back, it may fall to the front, which is dangerous. What you want to do, or what I do, is I use my last finger here to maintain the stack. So that in any case, if I want to ensure it doesn't fall, I tilt the stack towards myself, or rather towards the last finger, so the last finger acts as a leverage to prevent the deck from falling down. Bend the finger down, close the stack up, and you're done. And that's how you cut the deck into half with one hand.